According to the UNHCR report, on top of 2,000 children that are unaccompanied, more than 1,000 children are also separated from their parents. The children entered Uganda through Bunagana border and has since been camped at Chakabande Refugee Holding Center in Chisoro District. Lachin Hassanova, the head of UNHCR field office in Nachivale Refugee Settlement Camp, says the agency has identified foster families that are willing to take care of them.
Yes, we have also among new arrivals unaccompanied and separated children. And as of now, since the beginning of the refugee influx, we have about 2,000 plus unaccompanied children and also 1,000 plus separated children. For these unaccompanied children, we have protection partners. They are dealing by the support of child protection officers from UNHCR. They are dealing with the issues of unaccompanied and separated children. The first thing, when they are coming to Kisoro Nyakabande Transit Center, they are our child protection partners, and they are doing BIA, which is basic identification assessment, but very, very simple one. And then when they come to Nakivale, we are doing a comprehensive BIA to understand their needs and also to understand whether they have relatives or they have families, and if they have, in which settlement they are. And we are trying to locate the family members or parents of these children when we receive them in Nakivale, and we reunify them with their families or relatives.
These foster families, according to Hassanova, are being supported by UNHCR to take care of these children.
They don't have anybody, and we cannot locate or identify anybody to reunify them with those relatives or families. In that case, we go for alternative care or foster care arrangements. So we identify foster families who are willing to take care of these children, and these foster families also are being supported to take care of these children. These are the measures so far we are dealing with unaccompanied children.
Well, I may not be able to have the exact number, but I know there are several of them, except in July, is where we had a very high number. I think there were almost about 2,000 of such cases, but we realized some of them were really purporting to be separated children. But I think for some reasons of attracting attention from partners, the parents and children decided to just separate themselves like that. But then technically, the teams handling child protection were able to realize that the number was slightly abnormal.
According to the 2018 report from UNICEF, Central Region Field Office, out of an average of 869 Congolese refugees that arrive every day in Uganda from the Democratic Republic of Congo, 61% of the arrivals are children.
Children who come without parents are profiled right from the entry, that's at the transit center, by the different partners that manage child protection or children-related issues. And when these cases are profiled, of course, they do an intensive technical interview to establish who they are exactly. And then after that, we then relocate them to the different settlement, and we do refer them. There's a proper, clear referral mechanism right from the transit center to the settlements, whereby the different partners operating at the transit refer to their colleagues or even same organizations that are working in the settlement for proper follow-up.
Out of the more than 2,000 children that have been received at Chakabande Refugee Holding Center in Chisoro District, UNHCR says only 438 children have so far been settled at Nachivale Refugee Settlement Center in Isinjiro District. Maureen Abina, the acting refugee officer in the office of the Prime Minister, says the foster homes are fast accessed technically by experts for the protection and dignity of children.
Foster care parents, these are assessed also technically by expertise who are handling child protection to ensure that the safety and dignity protection of these children is number one. So that's how they are being managed.
We continuously monitor their situation, that how they are coping and how they are managing. and of course the continuous support to foster families also going on.
Yesterday morning, war resumed in DRC after government forces clashed with M23 rebels who had been at Bunagana for 6 months. Jonathan Tusingwire for the news.